In his opening remarks made at the two-day consultative workshop on constitutional and electoral reforms, NUP President Robert Kyagulanyi asked his counterparts to focus their efforts on pushing for change.
We all know that the cornerstone of democracy is a constitution that guarantees the rights and freedoms of its citizens. Our constitution should be protected from manipulations and amendments which serve the interests of individuals as opposed to the interests of the nation. Friends, Ugandans yearn for a country where no one is above the law, where the judiciary operates without fear or favor, ensuring that justice is served to everybody.
He claimed that the current political environment is too harsh to tolerate electoral and constitutional reforms that can foster good governance.
Should be free from intimidation and violence when they go for elections. All forms of intimidation and violence should be condemned and punished. The rights of every voter, regardless of their political affiliation, must be respected and must be protected.
To also try and offer ourselves the necessary motivation that we offer us the energy desired out of our blocks, beyond the rhetoric of the need for reforms, be them electoral or constitutional, by resolving to take necessary positive steps towards the talk.
At the event that brought together opposition members of parliament, politicians, activists and political scholars, the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, emphasized that Ugandans should be concerned about the shrinking political space and democracy in the country.
We don't have to belabor so much about the cause of our current crisis, which has put the country in almost an existential crisis, graduating steadily into a ledge of democracy pariahs, an unenviable state of affairs 6 years after obtaining what was supposed to be our independence.
Makerere University Dean Professor Mwambusha Ndebesa, one of the facilitators at the event, said Uganda's political problems stem from a weak foundation for the constitution.
The 66th constitution was presented to parliament, and the members of parliament were asked to pick the draft in their pigeonhole and pass it. And members passed it without debating it. Members of parliament extended themselves into office for another 5 years without going for elections.
Members of parliament and other political actors expressed their opinions on alternatives available for the opposition to achieve its objectives.
The question is not an election scheduled on a date given and those that are managing it appointed. It is a question of whether or not the election is itself free and fair. Now, we have never had an operationalization of multi-party political dispensation. All we have had is one single entity stifling all the processes and the capacities of other parties.
When we come in a constitution stroke electoral reforms conference, that means we are not going to stop here. We are going to go past this conference because we are going to go with the reforms and we table them on the floor of parliament.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.